Hi, it's Cindy. Thanks for following my blog. If you'd like more information, scroll down and you'll see all the information that we're videoing as well as articles that you can review, pass to your friends and family. Today we're talking about short sales. The skinny on short sales are that the concept is long. If you need to close on something quickly, you're getting married, moving out of a house, coming back from school, coming in from overseas, and you need a 60-day close, a short sale is not the way to go. Short sales typically mean the seller owes more than the property is worth. So perhaps they've talked to the bank and between the two of them, they've decided that they could take the property short. The way that works is, of course, the realtor sets the price with the seller, who is still the homeowner. They create the price, put it in MLS, market it, and try to get a buyer. Over time, sometimes those short sale prices come down. Doesn't mean the bank will accept that. The seller may sign off on that short sale, then it has to get presented to the bank. It's a long process typically. It could be 6 to 9 months, just depends. If the short sale doesn't get approved, ultimately the bank takes it back, the property forecloses. So people ask all the time, aren't these great deals? They can be good values, but you have to have a good amount of time to wait for that deal to come in. Other ideas to consider for the short sales are condition, location. Perhaps the client tried to sell in a different year and couldn't sell it, so why didn't it sell? So these are all things and factors to keep in mind. Again, please pass this information on to family and friends and visit us on Facebook. Thanks.